Okay, so in this session, we continue our discussion on the real life applications of the concepts of the HCF and LCM. And in this session, we will focus on how do we apply the idea of finding a least common multiple or a lowest common multiple to a practical scenario. So let us take this problem. So the problem is something like this. In a morning walk, there are three persons. They step off together, so they start walking. Now the steps are in different size, and their steps measure 20 centimeter, 25 centimeter and 30 centimeter respectively. So let us say that we have three persons, person A, person B and person C. And person A's step size here is 20 centimeter. Person B, he will take a step size of 25 centimeter, and the person C will take a size of 30 centimeter. Now the question here is, what will be the minimum distance that each should walk so that all can cover the same distance in complete steps? So here is the goal. What is the minimum amount of distance that all of them should walk so that they cover same distance? So now if we analyze the situation a bit, let us say that all these three persons A, B and C start walking. So when the person C takes the first step, she will be ahead 5 centimeters as compared to the person B. And when the person B takes the first step, he will be 5 centimeters ahead of the person A. And assuming that all of them take the steps at the same time, this 5 centimeter difference between 5 centimeter distance difference between these three will keep on increasing. But then they will come at a point where all of them would have covered the same distance. And that is what we need to find out. So we need to analyze the problem. So the first requirement says that the distance covered by all of them should be the same. That is, we need to find out. I mean, all of them, they can walk different steps, but they have to cover the same distance. And yet it should be the minimum distance for that person, right? Even though it is the same distance, but it should be minimum for that person according to the size of the steps they are taking. So what it means is that, hence, we can say that each person should travel steps equal to the lowest common multiple of the steps. Now, why the lowest common multiple? Because this is the smallest number for which each of these numbers, that is the 20 centimeter, 25 centimeter and 30 centimeter, is going to be a factor of. So you can see all these three numbers, 20, 25. So let us say that we want to find out some distance, right? Some distance which can divide, when which could be divided by 20, 25 and 30 equally. That is what. And that the distance that we want to find should be the minimum possible. That is why we are using the concept of an LCM over here. So we proceed to solve the problem by finding the LCM of the steps. So here is what we have done. We have written a table over here and written 20, 25 and 30 in three columns. And then we start our division procedure as we learned earlier. So we first start with the smallest prime number, which is 2. And we see what all can be divided by 2. So 2 multiplied by 10 is 20. 25 remains as it is, and the number 30, so 2 multiplied by 15 is 30. Now is again we can see that in this all three columns 10 number can still be divided by 5 further, so we will just write 2 5s are 10, 25 remains as it is, 15 remains as it is. Now we check for the next prime number which can divide any of these numbers here, and you can see that 3 will be the number because 15 can be divided by 3. So 5 remains as it is, 25 remains as it is, and 3 times 5 is 15. So now what is the next prime number? As you can obviously see that we'll have the number 5 here. So 5 times 1 is 5, 5 times 5 is 25, and again 5 times 1 is 5. Okay, and then we still have 1, 5 left, so we'll add, put it one more time. So we have 1, 1 and 1 here. So now the LCM for the steps of the persons would be 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5. So we just take a product of these numbers over here, and when we simplify this, so we have 4 multiplied by 25, which 2 into 2 is 4, 5 into 5 is 25 multiplied by 3. So we have 100 into 3, which is equal to 300 centimeters. Right? So what this means is each and every person should walk 300 centimeters so that they will be covering minimum distance for them respectively according to their distance. So this is the distance where all of the persons will meet. Now, having said that, let me give you some ideas on how you can figure out whether you would like to apply HCF or an LCM to a given problem. But before we do that, let us take one more problem. And in this, what we are supposed to do is we need to find the least number which, when divided by 12, 16, 24, 36, leaves a remainder 7 in each case. Okay, so now if you see that we have to find the least number which can be divided by all of these 4 numbers, that is 12, 16, 24 and 36. So as it suggests clearly, we need to take LCM. Now what do we do about 7? I will talk about that later. First, let us find out the LCM. So we start with the prime number, smallest prime number, which is 2. And then we can see that 2 times 6 is 12, 2 times 8 is 16, 2 times 12 is 24, and 2 times 18 is 36. So we can still divide these numbers by 2 further. So we'll continue on. 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, 2 sixes are 12, and 2 nines are 18. We can still divide this by 2 further. So 2, 3 remains as it is. 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 3 is 6, 9s remain as it is. We still have 1, 2 here. So we just write 2, 3 remains as it is. 2 times 1 is 2. This remains as it is, and 9 remains as it is. Now you can see that in this columns we can divide by 1. So this becomes 3 times 1 is 3. The 1 is as it is, and again 3 times 1 is 3, and 3 times 3 is 9. So now we have 1, 1, 1 in these 3 columns, and we have 1, 3 here. So what we are going to do is we are going to take one more 3, and then we write 1s in all these 3 columns, and 3 times 1 is 3. So now we have the LCM for these numbers as 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. So you have 2 times 2 is 4. Okay. And again 2 times 2 is 4 into 3 into 3. So we here have 12 times 12. 4 into 3 is 12, and 4 into 2, which is equal to 144. Right? So now we got the LCM. However, if you look at the problem, it says it should leave a remainder 7 in each case. So what I'm going to do is I just add the number 7. So what we'll do is we'll add 144 plus 7. So what we get here is 151. Now you can check this answer for yourself. What you can do is you just take this number 151 and try to divide it by 12, 16, 24 and 36. So whenever you do that, you will be able to divide this 151 by all of these numbers, and the remainder will be 7. That is because what we have done. So this is a little bit indirect way of applying LCM. So now, as I told you earlier, let us move on and proceed to see how can we understand whether we need to provide an HCF or LCM for a given problem. Now if you have a look at the first problem in which we tried to apply the HCF, right, we were asked to find out the size of the biggest size of the container, right? So what you should do is you should look out for words like maximum, greatest and biggest. Wherever you have these type of words, it means you have to find out the highest common factor in that case. Okay, and when you look out for words like minimum, least or smallest, you can use LCM in that case. So, I mean, if you see in the previous two examples that we saw for the LCM, we were supposed to find out the least quantity. For example, in the first problem where three persons were walking, we were supposed to find out the least distance that all of these should travel, right? So you can look out for words of this type. So this will help you to identify whether you need to calculate the highest common factor or the least or the lowest common multiple for a given problem. So with that, we complete our chapter on playing with numbers. See you soon.